until now, Donald Trump is the new 45th president of the United States. Whether you win the Electoral College, those who voted for third-party candidates and didn't even vote, it doesn't matter. We can choose to protest this or recount votes, but we need to really start understanding what will happen under President Trump. As the new president, Trump has the power to nominate new cabinet members to be approved by the Senate. According to Article 2, Section 2 of the Constitution, the role of the cabinet is to advise the president on any subject that he may require, relating to the duties of each member's respective office. For example, if the president needs advice on energy policies and technology, he could appeal to the member he chose to lead the Department of Energy. Therefore, the cabinet has the ability to strongly influence the president's decision, especially on a subject that the president may not be as familiar with. It can influence something as simply regulating the railroads or something as important as whether or not to vote for them. So, of course, who the president picks to be on his cabinet is a very important decision that could possibly change the fate of the administration. As Donald Trump was slowly starting to announce the decisions for his cabinet, a man named Myron Abel was seen as a possibility to lead an environmental protection agency, or the EPA. The EPA was created on December 2, 1970 by Richard Nixon, who stated that by conscious choice, we transform our land into what we want it to become, according to Alexis Mandeville of the RNA. Nixon went on to pass the Clean Air Act in 1990 to control ozone-depleting substances. Currently, a few of the EPA's purposes are to ensure that environmental risks are reduced based on the best available scientific information, and that all parts of society have access to accurate information in managing environmental risks, according to the EPA's website. I want to persuade you that Myron Abel is not only the wrong choice for this position in the cabinet, but also cannot achieve the goals that the environmental protection agency has. Myron Abel, a 63-year-old climate change denier, is being seriously considered by Trump to run the Environmental Protection Agency. According to the New York Times, Abel has already been chosen by Trump to run a transition program to completely undo the climate change policies that were made under the Obama administration. Abel is also a leader of a group called the Cooler Heads Coalition, which states that it is focused on dispelling the myths of global warming by exposing flawed economic, scientific, and risk analysis. Myron Abel is known as one of the nation's most prominent climate change deniers, despite the overwhelming evidence of its existence. He constantly mocks climate change leaders like Al Gore, calling the fight against climate change the forces of darkness because they want to turn off the lights all over the world. The New York Times states that Abel even called Pope Francis' stance on climate change scientifically ill-informed, economically illiterate, intellectually incoherent, and morally obtuse. In an interview with PBS, Abel called the global climate change phony, and that the so-called global warming consensus was not based on science, but was a political consensus, which included a number of scientists. Fortunately, no one has been chosen for the cabinet position just yet, but Abel still seems to be one of the top contenders. Some others that are being considered are the following: Scott Pruitt, Leslie Rutledge, and many others, according to Andrew Restuccia of Politico. But unfortunately, these other choices aren't much better than mine. Most of them share the same stances on protecting our environment and climate change. As a person who is very concerned about the Earth's future, I hope that Trump can see what a future there is. There is overwhelming evidence that global climate change is a real threat. These three pieces of data provided by NASA are just a few of many indications of worsening climate change. According to NASA, CO2, or carbon dioxide, is heat trapping gas that is released from our everyday activities like deforestation and burning fossil fuels. First shows a graph of monthly CO2 emissions from January 2005 to the present. As you can see, emissions have gradually gotten higher and higher with no signs of dropping. infrared photos of the Earth in 2002, 2008, 2020, and 2014. The yellow and red colors indicate very high CO2 emissions. And as you can see, by 2014, the Earth is at least all yellow. Rising CO2 emissions are directly related to the rising Earth temperatures. This data, also from NASA, shows how Earth temperatures have dramatically risen from 1884 to 2018. The threat of climate change affects us all, and will continue to dramatically worsen until we know, which is guaranteed to happen if evil becomes the new head of the EPA. The current problem that climate change is affecting is sea level, and if it continues to rise, most of our coastal cities will eventually flood. According to Justin Gillis of the New York Times, with rapid melting of polar ice caps, the sea levels are expected to rise over 160 feet, which would almost completely submerge the Arctic Ocean mountains in Paris. Not only are we expecting a rise in sea levels and the loss of our coastal cities, the worst case scenario, as stated by Gillis, is the collapse of food production followed by mass starvation all around the world. Despite the seemingly undeniable evidence, Myron Eagle still questions the validity of these data. As I stated earlier, one of the main promises of the EPA is to reduce environmental risks based on the best available scientific information. Myron Eagle is unfit to run the Environmental Protection Agency because he cannot meet one of the most fundamental standards. The fact that he denies all valid scientific data proves that he cannot be a part of the program. The entire aim of the Environmental Protection Agency is to protect the environment, and Google is completely unable to do that with the views that he holds. As climate change becomes a growing threat to the entire world, we simply cannot afford to ignore the fact that we are in trouble if this goes on for much longer. To help this issue, I encourage you all to stay informed and educated on the topic of climate change, and what is and hopefully will be done to solve the problem. Unfortunately, we are unable to actually choose the climate members ourselves, but we can still understand what each member stands for and believes in. Keep in mind that the cabinet must be approved by the Senate, so if you feel strongly about climate change or any other topics, feel free to write our California Senators Barbara Boxer and Diane Feinstein, or Kamala Harris, who will be taking office in 2017, to express your opinions. You can also share your views with our senators online.